In class, we have done that reaction, chemical properties of an acid, and after that we are going to start that the first property we have done, reaction with the acid with the metal. Now we are going to start the second properties, and that is reaction with the metal metal carbonate. Okay, so this is the second part, reaction with metal carbonate. Metal carbonate, if I'm asking, you should know the formula for this metal carbonate. Yes, carbonate is CO3, isn't it? Carbonate is CO3 and charge is -2. Whatever metal we take, so some metal is, if it is metal, so of course it will have positive charge, isn't it? So M plus, and I don't know the charge, so let it be X. Okay, so what will be the metal carbonate formula? This will be M2CO3 and this will be X, isn't it? Got it? So similarly, if we have to make the formula of sodium carbonate, so sodium is +1 and carbonate is -2, so it will be Na2CO3. I'm not writing 1 over here because it is 1, so that's why I'm not writing. Got it? So this is metal carbonate. So what will happen, this reaction format you should know, whenever the metal reacts with, acid. Whenever the acid reacts with metal carbonate, two, three things I'm going to tell you over here, and that is very important and will work since long. Okay, see, work for long. Wherever you see that carbonate in the product, in the reactant side. Got it? If carbonate is there in the reactant side, there will be for sure product carbon dioxide. Got it? One product will be for sure. Okay? And if acid is there in the reactant side, it must be it will give you water as a side product for sure. Got it? Two things I have explained. If it is metal carbonate reactant side, then it will give you carbon dioxide on the product side. Yes? And if it is acid, that must product will be water. Now, next thing. Here what it will form, we will know it afterwards. Okay. One more thing I just want to say, that acid will never react with acid. Got it? An acid can never or will not react with the acid, another acid. So if these reaction is going to happen, that means it must be basic in nature. So what it will be? Basic. So we know that, got it, what I explained here, acid cannot react with an acid. If this reaction is going to happen, that means it must be basic, okay? And again, we know that if acid and base react with each other, it forms salt, got it? So whatever is will form over here, that will be considered as salt, got it? A very quick chemical test for an acid we will perform here. In an acid, add some carbonate to it, like calcium carbonate. The evolution of bubbles of carbon dioxide are evidence that the acid was used here. Geologists, to check the carbonate nature of an acid, pour acid on it, and if the fizzing is seen, then the rock is considered as carbonate. Okay? So, let me write it the big, that format I have written, so let it be. Now, example. Take any acid like H2SO4, isn't it? And the metal carbonate. Metal carbonate is, suppose that we are taking Na2CO3. So, what will happen? The must product, the fixed product, you can write. Carbonate is there, so carbon dioxide. Acid is there, so water will be there, isn't it? And what next? The salt will form. Salt formation, I have explained in the previous class. Salt is a cation and anion. Got it? So whenever we form a compound, the cation part should be first and the anion part will be afterwards. That means positive part will write first and then negative part. So in this case, see, this has gone for water. This has gone as a carbon dioxide. So what left in this case? This Na2 is left. So what is the charge over here? Plus, isn't it? and sulfate is left over here. What is the charge over there? Minus. So we will write Na first and then SO4. Now we have to put here ki what is. So Na is having plus 1 charge, isn't it? Na plus 1 charge, and sulfate is having minus 2. So what will be the compound? Na2SO4. Got it? Any doubt in this? Next reaction, if we do like another acid, HNO3, and this time I am taking calcium carbonate. What will be the formula of calcium carbonate? Calcium is plus 2 and carbonate is minus 2. So what will be the formula? CaCO3, isn't it? So the fixed product is CO2 and the water we will make. And what next? This is calcium and here NO3 is left. So Ca and NO3 will form. Now we have to put that. So Ca is having plus 2 and NO3 is having minus 1. So what will be the formula? CaNO3 whole twice, isn't it? Got it? Another example, if I'm taking like one, this is HCl, this time we are taking HCl, and any other metal carbonate, you can, like magnesium carbonate, let me take. Yes? So what will happen? CO2 will be product, water will be the product, and CO2 is gas, so write it in this way. Yes? And what next? Mg and Cl. So Mg is charged plus 2 and Cl is minus 1. So this will form MgCl2, isn't it? So this is the reaction. That means whenever, what I am explaining, whenever acid reacts with metal carbonate, it will form a salt along with the carbon dioxide and water. Got it? So this is the important point. And here I have explained 3 points. I think it is clear. Let me revise this. If acid is there, for sure water will be there in the product. If carbonate is there, for sure carbon dioxide will be there in the product. And since it is acid, so it must react with the base only. It cannot react with the acid. So whenever acid and base react with each other, they form salt. So this is the salt. Got it? Any doubt in this? If there is any doubt, you can ask. Okay? So now the next reaction we are going to do, third, the reaction with metal bicarbonate, with metal hydrogen carbonate or bicarbonate, both are same thing, hydrogen carbonate, that is also known as bicarbonates. Okay, so how to write this equation? So again the same thing, if acid reacts with metal hydrogen carbonate, what is the formula of hydrogen carbonate? Do you know? Yes, you have done in class 9th. Just recall it. This is HCO3 minus, isn't it? HCO3 minus, and whatever the charge on metal, suppose at X, so what will be the metal carbonate formula? M, this will 1, so obviously it will come over here 1, and this HCO3X, whatever the metal charge we will write over here, isn't it? So whenever metal carbonate reacts with hydrogen carbonate, since it is acid, so what is the must product? Water. Got it? And since again here is the carbonate, so it will form carbon dioxide, isn't it? And the another thing I told you, that if it is acid, it must be base. So acid and base react to form salt. So this will also form salt. Got it? Any doubt in this? We will do this reaction with an with the help of an like activity also. Okay? So now, let me take an example. If for this, suppose that HCl is going to react with this NaHCO3. So what will happen? For sure, carbon dioxide gone. For sure, H2O. Yes. And what left? Na from this and Cl from this. It will form NaCl. Doesn't it? Any doubt in this? if it needs to balance, you have to, you are supposed to balance it, okay? Like here, you can balance it by 2, adding 2 over here. In this case also, you need to balance over here too. Got it? Any doubt in this? Okay, so now, another example. Take another example, like H2SO4 and this NaHCO3. It will give you Na, we'll do afterwards, first CO2 and water, that is the mass product, so we'll make, and next is Na and C. 2 and 3 H is there. Out of that, only 2 is used. Got it? So 1 H is left. So NaH and SO4 are left. So what it will form? NaHSO4. In this case, it was not like hydrogen was only 2. 1 and 1, 2. So that's why that's used up as a water. So no need to make a NaHCl. Got it? But in this case, 2 and 1, 3 hydrogen is there. So out of the 3, 2 has gone for water formation, 1 is left, so that will come in this case. Yes? So another example, let's do with this, suppose that another acid, HNO3, yes? So if it is going to react with another sodium another carbonate, let me take, okay? So what will form? Carbon dioxide and water will be there for sure. Now just check. How many hydrogen? 1 and 1, 2. Isn't it? So 2 is used up. Carbon dioxide on 1 oxygen is used up. 2 oxygen is used up. But 1 oxygen is left over here. Isn't it? So this, if you will write CaHNO3, it won't be balanced. Check. To balance it, we will write CaNO3 whole twice only. Now you'll say that how come that it is having hydrogen and other places we are not taking. So just I'm going to tell you one thing, that bicarbonate and bisulfate are only possible, not any other any other ion. Got it? What I said? Bicarbonate, that means carbonate ke pehle H laga sakte hain, and bisulfate, that means sulfate ke pehle H laga sakte hain. Rest, nitrate ke pehle ya phir chloride ke pehle, nothing, no, we will not use. Got it? So that is the reason it forms. Any doubt in this? Yes, class? Okay. Now, just to write some important point here, like NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate, NaHCO3. This is also used as, or is known as, hydrogen carbonate, so that already I have written. Okay, another thing, baking soda. We will do it again afterwards, and the salt away we will do. Okay, baking soda, then baking powder. Still, it is like a little difference between this baking soda and baking powder. I will tell you afterwards. Okay, there next, bread soda. It is also known as bread soda. And bicarbonates of soda. Okay. So now this carbon dioxide gas is evolving out. How can you identify, how can you confirm this, that carbon dioxide gas is identified? One experiment I have explained about that hydrogen gas, that burning matchstick is brought to the mouth of the test tube, then it will give you the pop sound. Another test to distinguish carbon dioxide, to distinguish or to confirm release of carbon dioxide. Yes? What it is? To confirm the gas evolved is carbon dioxide by the reaction of an acid with sodium bicarbonate, we can use the simple setup. Pass the carbon dioxide gas through lime water, which is the solution of calcium hydroxide. After a few seconds, white milkiness is seen, which is a microscopic specks of insoluble calcium carbonate being made in the reaction. pass this gas bubble through it for long, and hence, in the reaction, carbonic acid will be formed, which reacts with insoluble calcium carbonate to make it soluble calcium hydrogen carbonate, as shown, leading to a clear solution. So, when this the reaction is done and this gas is evolving, so now this gas is passed through CO2, the released gas is passed through lime water, which turns it into milky. The formation of this milky white form because of the CaCO3. This conversion of that solution in milky confirms that presence of carbon dioxide. Got it? Which proves the presence of carbon dioxide. Got it? Okay. So, what is the reaction? Let me write the reaction. CaOH whole twice. How it forms? Actually, lime water is this. CaO. Okay, this is lime water. When this lime water is dissolved in water, it forms slaked lime. First, it will form slaked lime. Okay. And in this, actually, we are passing the gas in this solution, but finally, it has turned into this. Okay. So, when we pass the carbon dioxide gas through it, it will give you CaCO3 and that water. This is an insoluble substance and it will settle down. Niche, bad jag, aapka, it's a precipitate. And this will convert this milky. Not properly, it will settle down a little bit, okay? So, this turns the solution in milky. So, this proves the release of carbon dioxide gas. Now, what happens if excess of carbon dioxide gas is released, okay? If excess of carbon dioxide gas is passed through it, passed through this solution. This solution, that means lime water, okay? Then the solution turns into the milkiness disappears. Then the solution or the milkiness of the solution disappears. That means it becomes a clear solution. Disappears. It becomes a clear solution. So, what is the reaction? Now, this CaCO3 will form if an excess of carbon dioxide gas is passing through this. So, it will form CaCO3H2O in this way. Okay. But still, we are continuing with the passing of this carbon dioxide. So, this will form CaOH whole twice. Calcium bicarbonate whole twice. And this is a what? Clear solution. This is a clear solution. Got it? Now after this, we will do the next reaction. That is fourth. The reaction of acid with marble. And eggshell, and you will be surprised to know that both has formula CaCO3. Either you say marble or you say eggshell, both have formula CaCO3 only. Got it? So since marble or eggshell is made up of carbonate, made up of calcium carbonate. So when acid is poured over it, that the bubbles of carbon dioxide is formed, okay, or it will evolve, like will come up. So the same reaction we will do CaCO3. Suppose that any acid I am using, like HCl I am using, H2SO4 you can use, HNO3 you can use. So any acid, what it will give? Carbon dioxide, and water will be for sure because it is an acid, and the next product is calcium carbonate, the main product, okay. To make it balance, it will be like this, isn't it? Okay, now uses of acid, and afterward we will start the very important point, uses of acid. Okay, let me do all this thing and then we will do that base, but before that I am thinking to start the pH. Okay, so after doing pH we will start the base. So first, uses of acid, try to understand this, what it is, like these are the points you have to learn. That the sulfuric acid is also known as king of chemical, you know, sulfuric acid, this is king of chemicals, is used in car batteries, used in car or automobiles batteries, yes. And another thing is also used in inverters jo ghar mein hum use karte hain to convert that light, you know. Okay, and also used for preparation of many compounds, Now next is nitric acid. Nitric acid, it is used in preparation of ammonium nitrate, which is used as fertilizer in agriculture. Okay, third point, think of it, hydrochloric acid, write some use of that also. Hydrochloric acid is HCl, okay. Hydrochloric acid, this is used for cleaning, is used for cleaning purpose, like toilet and basins and all that, for this we can use. Okay, now next, there are many, like tartaric acid, it is used for, have you heard this word, tartaric acid, baking powder, have you heard? Tartaric acid is a main or is a is constituent of your baking powder. जिससे आपको use करते हो cakes and इसमें use baking करने में, so that is baking powder. We will do it in detail. Okay, baking powder. Now some salts, like salts of benzoic acid, although you don't know this benzoic acid kya hota hai, salts of benzoic acid, that is used for preserving, this is sodium benzoate, we say, okay, the name of this compound is sodium benzoate. It is used for preserving the pickles. Okay, so salts of benzoic acid is used for preserving द पिकल्स लाइक 1 या 2 ईयर्स के लिए हमें जब प्रिजर्व करना होता है तो वी शुड एड दिस जैम जेलीज ऑन ऑल दैट. ओके फूड प्रिजर्वेशन यू कैन राइट और अदर फूड और व्हाट वी से और अदर फूड राइट डाउन और अदर फूड. ओके नेक्स्ट व्हाट वी से नेक्स्ट इज कार्बोनिक एसिड. कार्बोनिक एसिड इज H2CO3. Got it? Carbonic acid formula is H2CO3. This is an important or this is an constituent or ingredient of the aerated drink. All that aerated drinks like Pepsi, Coke, yes, in some carbonic acid is an ingredient. Okay. After this, we are going to start the base. Okay. As we have defined for the acid, Arrhenius acid we have defined. Similarly, we will define for the base. Okay. Arrhenius base we are doing. So, according to this Arrhenius, according to Arrhenius concept, the substances which produces or which releases OH minus ion on dissolving in water is known as base. The substances recover. So let me write with this R. Okay, known as bases. Clear? Okay. So like bases, jo hote hain, what is a litmus test? So it turns red litmus into blue. Got it? Red litmus into blue. And if you use the pH paper, then also it will convert it into blue color. Change the blue color. Okay? They are, if we use the phenolphthalein, so they are pink with the phenolphthalein. They are pink with phenolphthalein. And yellow with methyl orange. Okay. Methyl orange. Clear? So this is the pH and they are bitter in taste. Okay. Bitter in taste. Now, classification of bases. We'll do that. Classification of bases. As we have done for the acid, same. Classification of bases. First, let me do with this based on ionization. Okay. So, the one which will be completely ionized will be considered a strong base. And the one which will not completely ionize will be considered as weak base. Okay. So, how one is known as strong base and another one is weak base. Like in acid, we can see that it is complete ionization or not. But here we cannot see that complete ionization is there or not. Okay. Just you have to learn something. I can give you the trick for this. Strong bases which completely ionize into its ion. Okay, like NaOH, KOH, etc. And weak base which do not completely ionize, that you have to learn, which do not completely ionize. Completely ionize. Now the example is CaOH hold twice, MgOH hold twice, like this. NH4OH. Now, if you will dissociate it, it will give you Na plus and OH minus. This will give you K plus OH minus. You can see that whatever the OH is present over here, it is releasing. Here also, if you will dissociate it, this will give you Ca plus 2 and 2 OH minus. Similarly, this will give you Mg plus 2 plus 2 OH minus. And this will give you NH4 plus and 2 OH minus. So you can ask that here whatever the OH is there, that also it is releasing. But still it is weak and it is strong. How come? So actually this is experimental. Experimentally observation concept is there, so that you have to learn. I can give you one trick for that. If group 1, might be you have learned in that first chapter, I have told you. Lina ki rab se faryad. So you don't have to learn this. L-I-N-K. Group 1. If OH is with these three. OH is with these three. Okay. Then it will be considered as strong base. But if these three are not there. If these three are not there. Then it will be considered as weak base. Got it? So you can see here. LINAK out of all these three, is there anything? No. So that's why it is weak acid. Here Na is there, here K is there. So that's why it is strong acid. Got it? So this is based on ionization. Okay. Now, second point, based on acidity. Based on acidity. I have told you when I was teaching that as acid, that acid will have basicity and bases will have acidity. Got it? So what we have defined, how have we have defined the number of OH minus given, the number of, in that basicity we have learned that number of H plus given by an acid is known as basicity of an acid. Similarly, here we will learn the number of OH minus ion given by any base is called acidity of base. Got it? So it can be monoacidic, isn't it? That means it will give you only one OH minus. Example, let's do this. KOH, NaOH, this can give only one OH. Yes. NH4OH, isn't it? Now, diacidic. Diacidic, that means which will give 2 OH minus. Can you give me example for this? Yes. Yes, correct. CaOH hold twice. Next is MgOH hold twice, isn't it? So this is diacidic. Now, triacidic. Can you think of it? Triacidic. Just think of it for 1 minute at least. Okay, this is AlOH whole thrice, FeOH whole thrice, etc. This is triacidic. Got it? Now third one is based on concentration. So as we have done for the acid, similarly we are doing here also. Okay, concentration, it can be of two type. One is dilute and another is concentrated, isn't it? Concentrated. Okay. So dilute when base amount is less. Base amount is less in comparison of water. Of water in its aqueous solution. This is dilute. But when base amount is more in comparison of water in comparison of water in its what aqueous solution, then it is called concentrated. Example, I can write, like, if I'm writing 5% of NaOH solution and when I'm writing 90% of NaOH solution, what does it mean? This 5% of NaOH, it means that only 5 gram of NaOH is dissolved in 95 gram of water, isn't it? Then both will combine to form 100. And here it means 90 gram of NaOH is dissolved in 10 gram of water. So which one is dilute and which one is concentrated? Yes, of course, this one is dilute and this one is concentrated, isn't it? Got it? Similarly, this year in the board there was a question, what do you mean by 5%? What do you mean by 5% of KMnO4? So can you tell me what does it mean? It means that 5 gram of KMnO4 is dissolved in 100 gram of solution or 95 gram of water. Got it? See, solution means solute and solvent, isn't it? Solvent in general, aqueous solution, we take water. Got it? Yes. So solute is here KMnO4. So what does it mean? It means that 5 gram of KMnO4 is dissolved in 95 gram of water, you can say, or what else you can say? This and this will combine to form solution, so you can say, or 5 gram of KMnO4 is dissolved in its solution, isn't it? Got it? Hope all this concept is clear. If there is any doubt, you can ask. Okay. Next topic, we will start the reaction of base with the metal. Okay. As we have done for the acid. So that we will do in next lecture. Till then, thank you, class.